Many people find it illogical that so much money is invested in knowing outer space, other planets, other galaxies, when we can't even say that we know our planet. And the truth is that our planet at this point is still a great mystery for us. It is estimated that we only know 5% of the seabed. The remaining 95% remain unmapped. Taking into account that the ocean represents more than 70% of the planet Earth, there is no doubt, we don't know our own world. Years and years of biological studies have allowed us to get to know a wide range of living beings of different shapes and sizes, and it has been the little exploration we have done to the oceans which has allowed us to discover fascinating living beings that escape our imagination and even many that seem to come from hell itself. Such is the case of the colossal squid, a species of squid that can reach up to 15 meters. Even testimonies of sailors say that they have seen even larger squid. Probably the colossal squid inspired the legend of the Kraken. The anguilla shark is another species discovered deep in the ocean that could petrify you from fear with just its appearance. The eel shark has a deadly characteristic, a dangerous jaw full of more than 300 teeth that form a sharp saw. The black devil, or abysmal monkfish, is a species of abysmal fish that belongs to the biological family of the Melanosidae, found in the tropics. It lives at depths normally of 3,000 to 4,000 meters. It has an antenna above its head that springs from its nose and whose tip is full of bioluminescent bacteria that illuminates to attract other fish to catch them with its large teeth. Another creepy-looking creature is the goblin fish. Do you manage to observe it well? Stop the video for a moment so you can understand its appearance. It is known of its existence since 1939, but it was not until 2004 when it was finally possible to obtain a photograph of this strange fish. It is also known by the name of transparent headfish due to its unique shape, in which its dome is full of transparent fluid, in which the inner part of its head can be seen the eyes, brain, and nerve endings. But curiously, the rest of his body does not have the peculiarity of transparency, being opaque. Its head is covered by a shield at the top, which allows it to withstand the poison produced by siphonophores and jellyfish, animals that it feeds on. No, it is not a computer-made animation, not a drone from a science fiction movie either. This is 100% real, non-fake image of the Crossata medusa, a species recently discovered in 2016 at almost 4,000 meters deep. That same year, 2016, another strange ocean floor species was described for the first time, the Xena turbella churro. It lacks a central nervous system, mouth, anus, or reproductive organ. In fact, yes, it is true. It looks like a dirty sock. In addition, there is something that all these animals have in common, the strange appearances they have, like this octopus, which seems to have come out of some cartoon. Strange doesn't always mean scary. It may also mean funny. There are still studies to determine their species. For now, it looks like a Pixar production in 4D. Have you ever wondered why the beings that inhabit the ocean floor are so strange? What happens to animals that live in the deep ocean is that they need to adapt to the hostile environment. In the deep ocean, everything is completely dark. Sunlight does not reach these areas. For this reason, most species discovered at the bottom of the ocean are completely or partially translucent. Many of these animals produce their own light inside their bodies. In these dark areas, it is really difficult to get prey and companions. That is why some of those creatures have developed large eyes and large nostrils. This is the case of the deep-sea hatchetfish, distributed by the abysmal waters of the Pacific, Atlantic, and Indian Ocean. Marine species that inhabit deep waters must also adapt to freezing temperatures that regularly range between -1 and 4 degrees Celsius, and also at a pulverizing pressure of up to 8 tons per square inch. Another strange feature of these environments is the high concentration of sulfur and liquid carbon dioxide that flows from vents on deep seabed. All these environmental conditions apparently would impede the development of life, but no, it seems that nature always finds its way. By the way, logic could tell us that perhaps these places where such overwhelming pressure exists could have allowed the development of giant monstrous creatures. Creatures like Leviathan, a sea monster from Semitic mythology. Perhaps these types of legends are inspired by real sightings made in ancient times. We do not know. And we will not know until we finish exploring the seabed in its entirety. To be able to understand what we are talking about, it is enough to see that the Mariana Trench, for example, has an area of territory 2,550 kilometers long and 69 kilometers wide, five times larger than the Grand Canyon. In the Mariana Trench is the Challenger Abyss. In 2014, researchers from the University of New Hampshire published the results of a seafloor mapping showing that the depth of the Challenger Abyss is 10,994 meters deep. This is 2,110 meters deeper than the height of the highest point on Earth, Mount Everest. So far, the only indication of what could be evidence of the existence of some giant sea beast are sounds that have been captured by researchers deep in the ocean. These researchers believe that they come from very large animals inhabiting very deep waters. While the investigations continue, we can only imagine what are the sources of these sounds and know if they have really been produced by huge creatures that are hidden deep in the seabed. I hope you learned something new today. If you still have some questions left, let us know in the comment section below. If you want to know what would happen if dinosaurs were still alive, click on the video given on your screen. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.